Hi guys, what's up? Raghu Sharma here, back with another video. So today in this video I'll be showing you how you can install and play YouTube on your car's infotainment system using Android Auto. Now your car's infotainment system can be a pre-installed one or an aftermarket one, but the thing is that it should support Android Auto on it. So here I have an OnePlus 6 Android phone, and using that I'll be demonstrating how to use YouTube on your car's infotainment screen. So a while ago I made a video which demonstrated how to play YouTube on the car's infotainment system using Apple iOS device, and on that video I got many comments of yours. So that's why I have made a video on how to use Android and play YouTube on the car's infotainment screen. So for that you have to firstly open Google Play Store and install the Android Auto mobile app. So here I am opening, and you can see we have to install this Android Auto for phone screen app right here. So I click install, and it will take a while to install, and as soon as it installs I will open it. Now when I try to open it, it closes itself because the data cable is connected to the car and Android Auto is working on the car's infotainment system. So I unplug the data cable, and now you can see it's opened. It may ask you for some permissions, so you have to grant it. After that, click on these three bars and go to settings. Over there, scroll to the bottom, and there you will see version and permission info. Tap it few times and it will say that you are now a developer. I think you have to tap it for 7 times. After that, this pop-up will come, click OK. So now you are a developer. Now when you will go to the top and click the three pins, and there you can see developer settings. You have to open that. After you have opened that, you have to scroll down and you have to search for an option known as unknown sources. Now what will it do is it will allow us to install unknown apps which are not on the Play Store on our device, which can work on Android Auto. So we have ticked it. After that you have to go to the top, and there is an option of application mode. You have to click it and select developer. Now pretty much the settings for this particular app is now complete. So we'll come back to the home screen and we'll open Chrome and type AA store on the Google search, and here I'll open this GitHub site. Now the link of this website will be given down in the description also. So here I will click the download link and a download will be started. So now this is an app called AA store. Through this we will be installing an app known as CarTube. So the CarTube will allow us to bridge our YouTube app to our car's infotainment screen. So here I am installing the AA store, and here you can see it's installed and it's now opening. So here it's installed. Now when I open the AA store, I can see the CarTube app on the top. Now this doesn't only have this single app, it has many apps on offer. So here I click the CarTube app and I will click install, and you can see the installation is in process and it is asking for some permissions. So I will grant all the permissions which it asks. So here I click install and CarTube is now installing, and it is finally installed. So this is these are some features of the CarTube. You can read it over here. So now I will open the CarTube app, and here you can see it also requires some permission. So I gave it the permission. And now the CarTube app is installed. Now I will connect my phone to my infotainment screen supporting Android Auto. As soon as I do it, you can see on the screen, car screen, Android Auto connected is written on the top. So now I will open the Android Auto, and here you see the CarTube app over here, just right here. Now I will open it. Now whenever we open it, it will give this warning: drive carefully and respect the rules of the road. Viewing the screen while driving can cause serious accidents. So we need to keep that in mind, as it's really risky. So now the phone is connected, and the YouTube is being projected on Android Auto on the car screen. Now I can search anything on YouTube over here. So for example, I will search my own video. Here I am searching Car Bridge Raghav. Now this is the video in which I have demonstrated how to install YouTube on iOS. Not on iOS, but it demonstrates how to use YouTube on car's infotainment screen if you have an iOS device. So that is using Car Bridge. So you can see that the video is working perfectly fine, audio is coming and everything is good. But now as soon as I push down the parking lever, which is the handbrake, you can see some features are not available while driving. So this YouTube will not work when you are driving. So it is a downside, but it is very much required for your safety. So now the AA store app doesn't only have that CarTube app as I told you earlier also, it has many other apps like the CarTube controller and all. And one other useful app which I found was Screen to Mirror, something like that. This one, Screen to Auto, I mean. So I am installing it right now, and as soon as it installs, I will show you. And here I open it, and it will ask for some permission. Now there is a catch that this app requires root permission, which is the super user permission. So this will not work if your phone is not rooted. In my case, this phone is rooted, so I have granted the root permissions, and you can see the app opens. And now what this app does is that it mirrors the screen from your Android phone to your car. Now I will open the Screen to Auto app on the car, and you can see the car screen is being projected just the same way as the phone screen is. So now this functionality is much more like the portal app in the iOS CarBridge tutorial which I showed for the iOS devices. So now there is a downside of this, that it will not work if your phone is in lock mode. It should be always screen on for this to work. And using this, you can use anything like YouTube or calling app, maps, anything, whatever is being shown on your phone will be similarly relayed to the car's infotainment screen. Now maybe Netflix or Prime Video may not work because of their security, that black screen will only come, but many apps will work. So now I am opening my video, and you can see this ad is coming. So what I mean to say is that YouTube will also work this way. So this is a second way. If one doesn't like the first way, they can use the second way, and likewise. So this is not better than the first one, but someone can like it because it has more functionality in YouTube. And other than YouTube, there are many things which can be opened, like compass, etc. So that was it for the tutorial. Now before you go, I have to tell you that I have another video of this Wi-Fi router battery UPS, which acts as a power bank to your router. When electricity goes, it will give power to your router, and your internet access can be uninterrupted. You can watch the review. The link will be provided in the I button and the description, and you can buy it from my link from Amazon. Also, if you are only stuck at watching YouTube, then I suggest you should also watch movies and original shows on Amazon Prime, which is only at $9.99 per year, and you will also get free delivery to your Amazon products and free music subscription. But if you are not a big fan of entertainment, then you should try Amazon Audible, under which you will be given free audiobooks for 1 month. You can start the free trial now. The link of it will be given down in the description. Thanks for watching my video. I hope it helped you. Don't forget to like my video and subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed watching it. Peace.